We're back with 5 minutes with Michael Benjamin to get all the wokeness you've ever fucking needed in life. So today's woke waves are presented by
Lightning Google's Toasted Bach.
All right, Michael, you got any bits for us before we ask you a few questions?
No, not exactly. I'm just curious what you guys have right now.
Just go right into the questions.
Yeah, I mean, I have some bits, but...
You're going to save them?
I'm going to save them.
You're saving the bits?
They're cooking. Yeah. Still cooking them
There's
bits.
There's still some bits that are cooking.
Right on. So, Chester, you got any questions for the MB?
I do, actually.
Fire them off.
All right, so I was thinking earlier about GPHOF, the Guy Party Hall of Fame, right?
Yeah, it's going to be elite.
Right.
Yeah.
Right, the inaugural class.
Mm-hmm.
And I was thinking, in the spirit of diversity, should we have a chick in the inaugural class? Or is it like, that's not Guy Party, it's Guy Party. Should we have a chick in our inaugural class? But this is a long-winded question. Then I started to think, who could I think of that would be worthy of that inaugural class? And I couldn't think of anybody. Like, and it made me wonder, like, is there a double standard there with men and women and how they're portrayed as boozeheads? Like, is it
winos versus boozeheads?
Is it funny and more acceptable for a dude to be a drunkard than it is for a woman?
I think you're kind of onto something, because yeah, it probably is true. It's like, if anything, it's acceptable for us guys, like, that we would, you know, throughout our tradition, for us to go and work our asses off, come home, be a fucking lush, and, you know, come home and get drunk and beat our wives. That was the norm. That was what we were supposed to do, right? I mean, we can laugh about it all we want, but that was what was fucking true, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And now we're like, oh, that was bad. What are you doing? What's wrong with you? And the people that are that age back then are like, what? What do you mean? You know, it's... I don't know. I mean, I feel like even with the women trying to, like, show their craziness nowadays... And how we've been able to see it, mm-hmm. with the internet and everything that's been going on, and what they even make, even if it's fake so much as they may make it, they're still trying to be as crazy as guys to be able to finally be able to push that envelope and be as, you know, being able to be accepted as being able to be drunk and winos and be like, look at me.
Do you think they're trying to push that envelope?
Yeah, for sure. Why wouldn't they
want to? That they wanted to be accepted as, like, degens?
They want to be able to be accepted as anything. It's not just a degenerate... It's anything a guy could be, you know?
Do you think they give that much of a shit?
It's not... Okay, maybe not all of them. I'm not saying like that, you know what I mean? But I'm saying, like, to a point where the ideology it needs to be, you know, is
there. It's like they want to get paid as much as us... And they want to be viewed as a big pieces of shit like us.
Yeah, yeah. They want to be able to be like, wait,
so
okay.
That's true.
Wait,
that's
so
fair.
That was, okay, I mean, here was this thing I saw the other day. I'm glad you brought up this question. It actually opens a quick thing about what I saw. It was just a meme, but it was still of an interview saying of a guy. Or no, it was of two porn stars that were going around like Hollywood or some shit, or Vegas on the strip or some shit, asking to see guys' dick pics, right? And the meme was like, no, like, yeah, but could two dudes, hot porn star dudes, get away with that and going up to women asking to see their fucking vagina pics? No. And that's what the meme said. And I was like, yeah, I guess that is true. That's the point. And I'm not saying it's okay either way, but at the same time, it's funny, like, to see the reactions on, versus the reactions on a dude's face, you know, getting approached by, like, porn stars, like, hey, let me see your dick pic. And I'm like, no, you don't want to see it, don't worry, you know. And but versus, like, a woman who got come up by two hot guys asking that shit or something.
Mm-hmm.
She'd be fucking hitting her with her spraying mace or whatever it was, you know.
You would turn that down, like, if two hot porn star chicks came up to you on the Vegas Strip and said, can I see your dick pic? You would say, nah.
It's not so much I said I would turn it down, it's just that, like, I'd be like, I said, you wouldn't, you don't want to.
Do you carry a microscope in your pocket for they can see it?
Well, that's the new app they got on my
oh,
phone.
There's an app on
yeah,
the phone.
It's a small penis app. You ever heard of it?
I assumed he had used some sort of Photoshop or magnifying.
Microsoft Paint.
It's actually what helps me pee. So, I mean, there's that.
The app finds it?
Yeah. It's pretty sad.
Are you furry down there?
I mean, I try to trim good, you know. Don't we all?
All right, so I got one last question for 5 minutes with Michael Benjamin. It's Guy Party. We do guy shit. I gotta ask you this, because you were talking about before we started recording. Was it worth being married?
Oh, worth being married. Isn't anything that's dangerous enough worth doing in life?
At least once.
Especially at least once. I wouldn't be that crazy enough to do it, like, three times or some shit like all these other people.
And Chester's pulling the trigger on it for twice.
Yeah, he is. And that's what I'm saying. That's why I said three and not two.
I'm dipping my toes back into that pool, and I'm okay with it.
Yeah, and that's why I said I wouldn't completely say no, be against it completely again one more time, but a third time?
You've been married twice?
No. I said I wouldn't be against doing it a second time. Gotcha. But I really would definitely not be doing
it. But like, if you tried again and it failed again, then you'd be like, nah.
Oh yeah, I am done. Because I mean, at that point, I mean, you know, it's like, really, truly for me right now at this point, I don't feel like it's just a piece of paper. It doesn't fucking matter.
Right.
It's only really to please them, you know.
But at some point, it's like, yeah, when you're our age and you're single, you can go on some like Tinder dates or whatever, and then like, maybe, like, one out of every 15 to 20 dates you manage to get laid. But once you get into, like, your 40s and especially your 50s, I don't know. Can you still pick up chicks at that point?
Can you even get hard enough to fuck?
I was just thinking about that the other day, about, like, people, like, say, like, you age, and you say if you, and that's why I was talking about the whole marriage thing. I'm glad I got, you know, my divorce out of the way quick, because I don't want to be one of those guys when I'm in my mid-40s that are, like, can't be, like, able to get, not a wife, but a relationship, because it's harder in your 40s and 50s, you know?
Or a boner.
Yeah, of course it's harder to get a boner when you're lonely. By that time, when we get to be that age, we'll have all the best robotics, you know, available.
That's true.
Everyone, thanks for tuning back in to 5 Minutes with Michael Benjamin. I hope he gave you guys some insight. Be sure to check it out next week. Yeah, folks.
Be ready for your robot sex dolls.
Yes.
And I don't mean to say dolls as in a feminine thing. It can be a man or a man or unimander.
Tranny dolls.
Unitran. Unigender.
Trans doll.
Anything you want, we can make it. You'll see.
Be sure to turn into Guy Party Podcast and get filled full of all the belligerence that we provide. Michael, your outro? Stay woke, folks.